Now, you two were having the great debate here on Outsiders. We never have the same opinions on everything, ever, heaven forbid. So in this instance, James and Rita going head to toe.
Especially on your tie.
I think we all agree on this one.
Does Kamala Harris have any values or not? Rita, you say she's an empty air head.
No. I say she will say whatever she needs to say to get ahead. I don't doubt that for a second. But that doesn't mean she doesn't have a belief system, an ideology. A lot of politicians will say whatever they need to say. Her voting record, I think, is clear. When she speaks off the cuff, you can see what she cares about. She is radically far left. She is far more left than Joe Biden. To try to present her as some sort of a moderate is an absolute lie. Even the most impartial judges said her voting record in the Senate was the most liberal, most left. But now they're trying to memory hole that. Mm. They're trying to disappear that history and present her as a safe pair of hands when we know she doesn't believe in borders. She doesn't, like you just said, even want to use the term illegal immigration.
Well, she doesn't want to use the term illegal immigration, and she doesn't want to even cop to being the border czar. And you know what else she doesn't want to cop to is being a DEI choice. Because, right, of course, this is another thing that's been disappeared here, is that Joe Biden had, of course, talked about, and people had talked about, you know, him picking a black woman to balance out his ticket with the old white guy when he
and you can't say that now.
No. And it's like, well, you know, I'm sorry, but if DEI is such a good thing, why aren't you proud of it? Embrace being the DEI candidate if you think it's so wonderful. My point, though, was that simply if you go back to her early career and every step along the way, what I'm saying is, yeah, I agree with you, Rita. She is very hard left. And if you think Joe Biden was to the left, she is quite far to the left of him. And the idea that she is going to get in now to office potentially on this TikTok vibe and this kind of, you know, Karen's
brat,
this, you know, the brat thing and Karen's for Kamala, I don't, you know, I find that horrifying because people actually need to look at her record. But what she's doing now is what she has always done, which is try to obscure what she believes in and say anything she needs to seem like a safe and presentable choice. That's the cynicism of it, and that's what I'm, really worried
about. I agree.
I think you shouldn't underestimate her only because she's got this media machine behind her now, which are going to just present her as this visionary, saviour, woman of colour, first female president. And we've seen just in this past week how they have just been Orwellian in denying things that we have known to be true for several years, rewriting history. And I don't think that's going to let up until November. I think they're going to just be Team Kamala, trying to cover up her missteps, trying to promote anything. And I think in a debate with Trump, of course, we play clips of her sounding like an idiot every week. She's not great, but unlike Biden, she can rehearse a few sharp lines and repeat them on cue and have a couple of those moments that are going to be highlighted by the media about, oh, she got Trump, she buried Trump. So I think in a debate, she can be dangerous for Trump. You can't deny that with a certain amount, a section of the demographic, Kamala has great appeal. The people who are obsessed with identity politics will vote for somebody because they're a woman or a woman of colour who's on the left. That is just a reality. You can say it's stupid, it should be based on merit, it should be based on policies, performance. Doesn't matter. It exists, and the Republicans are going to have to deal with that because that is a new challenge.